So I think it's an important institution, 150 years of service. And I think that it's more, it's not about certainly animal rights. You can go, we're going to tour the facility right here. Because these horses are well kept, the drivers are well trained. I think they add value to that, to the city. And that's why I'm here. I come from a union household. They know that I support workers and in every way that I can.
Please look here.
How you doing, man?
I'm doing good.
All right, then.
So we park the carriages here every night, and the horses live upstairs. And we'll come around and we'll see the see where the horses live in a moment.
How you doing, brother?
That's Charlie.
Huh?
Charlie.
Oh yeah, I did Silverado, Lonesome Dove, beautiful horses, Color Purple, I rode. Many times. I think when I did Silverado, I rode 6 months straight. I was on the horse almost every day. Well, I certainly see that they're well kept. That's obvious, you know what I'm saying? Well attended. I think people need to come by and see the product themselves, you know?
Including the mayor,
including the mayor, to see how these horses are kept. You know, and how these horses are treated, you know? And these are professionals right here. This is their bread and butter, you know? There's no reason why they wouldn't take care of these horses, you know?
just to let you know, they don't end up in some question because that's exactly. Them at home in the cats right now. I took those yesterday.
What's your name?
My name's Frank.
Frank, okay.
I'm
Frank.
You.
All right, okay. Nice to meet you. Thank you. 15 years?
She's the mother of all the horses.
She takes care.
She takes care of a lot of horses and people.
And the fact that we're even talking about it right now, and we're having the city council vote on such a measure, to me is really ridiculous. It's beyond. It's unconscionable, you know. And so many other things, you know. What about creating jobs, you know, in the city here? This business right here of showing people around the city, this wonderful city, this great city, through Central Park and all other parts of the city, having them opportunity to experience it through sitting outside in fresh air is something that we need to celebrate and commend.
We're fighting the fight.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Good. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
What's happening, which is, I believe it's unconscionable, you know, that these horses and these jobs are taken away from hardworking men and women who add value to the city, not only real aesthetic value is it's not all in buildings and how the highest building you can build, but aesthetic value is also financial value to the city. And well, I would tell the mayor, with all due respect, we a lot of things you've done I've approved of, but I think you're wrong on this. I know you're wrong on this, you know. And you need to go down to the stable. You need to come down here. Maybe you need to take a ride here in one of these carriages right now.
I got a better idea. How about getting 300 unemployed people and giving them tax medallions?
Yes.
Yeah.
So they can drive.
It's the same thing as Councilman, the same thing with the horses. 220 horses that already have homes, have good welfare, have regulation to protect them, but there's a hell of a lot more horses that don't.
I just even realized, and I may be in embellishing it a little bit, that is even more romantic was the first time. When I said romantic, I only meant the beauty of it. The beauty to be out here, to ride around here, and to be in this space, and to hear the sound of the horse hoofs hitting the pavement and everything else, you know, which is something that you take for granted, you know, and you accept it. You not only that, because it's been here so long, like many New Yorkers, and I think 64% of them said they don't want to lose that.
Any message to the mayor now?
or?
Well, it's the same message. I think the message that the mayor is right on a lot of things, but I think he's dead wrong on this. You know, he's dead wrong on this. And I hope that the city council includes him by voting and voting down this initiative.